everyone. Welcome back to Lucy Tutorials. In this video, I will show you how to access your freeform boards on your Mac, iPad, and iPhone. In other words, you want to be able to synchronize your freeform digital whiteboard between your Mac computer and iPad or iPhone using iCloud. Let's say you have created your first freeform board on your Mac desktop or laptop computer at home or in your office, and you want to be able to use the same board on your iPad or iPhone while commuting to work on a train or enjoying a cup of coffee in a coffee shop. To be able to synchronize your digital boards between your devices, you need to be logged in with the same Apple ID on all your devices. Your Apple ID is the email address and password you use to purchase apps on the App Store or for Apple products and services. In this tutorial, I will use a MacBook Pro and an iPad as an example. The settings on iPad and iPhone are similar. To access your freeform board on your iPad or iPhone, first click on the Apple logo in the top left corner of your screen and select System Settings. Click on your name or Apple ID in the left sidebar. Next, click iCloud on the right and scroll down until you see the freeform icon. Turn the switch on if it's not on. Your switch might have a different color, for instance, blue or green. In any case, make sure it is turned on. Now, close the System Settings window. Next, turn on your iPad or iPhone, tap on Settings, tap on your name in the left sidebar, and then tap on iCloud. In the following step, tap on Show All and scroll down until you see the icon for the Freeform app. Turn it on by clicking the toggle button. The freeform board you created on your Mac computer will immediately appear on your iPad or iPhone. However, I faced an issue when I typed a sentence on the sticky note in the freeform app on my MacBook. It was not synchronized to my iPad. But when I typed something on my iPad, it was immediately synchronized to my MacBook. To solve this problem, I signed out of iCloud and signed in again on my Mac and did the same on my iPad, and the issue disappeared. If you have faced a similar problem, sign out of your iCloud account and sign in again on both devices. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you learned something new from it, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to receive notifications of upcoming tutorials. Your support will encourage me to make more videos for you. Thank you for watching.